मॉर्निंग बॉयज, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू चैप्टर द वैदिक पीरियड. बॉयज, एवरी डे वी वर्शिप मेनी गॉड्स एंड गॉडेसेस. एवरी डे वी चांट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मंत्रस, फॉर एग्जाम्पल गायत्री मंत्र. बट कैन यू से व्हाट इज द सोर्स ऑफ दिस मंत्रस? Today we'll know what is the source of all these mantras. So, let's start our discussion.
Today let's take a brief look at the Vedic age. But before we get into the Vedic age, we need to talk a little bit about the Aryans. The Indus Valley civilization, which flourished between 3000 BCE, ended around 1700 BCE. Around 1800 BCE, the decline of the Indus Valley civilization was followed by the Aryans into the Indian subcontinent from Central Asia. A new culture and civilization emerged in India with the coming of Aryans. The Aryans were Indo-European tribes from Central Asia who migrated to the Indian subcontinent. They came to India through the Hindu Kush mountains and were subsequently referred to as Indo-Aryans. The Indo-Aryans spoke an ancient form of Sanskrit and had common cultural practices. In fact, the term Indo-Aryan is derived from the word Arya, which means kinsman. The Indo-Aryans first settled in the land of seven rivers in the Punjab region, also known as Saptasindhu. They named this land as the Brahmavarta, which means the abode of gods. Gradually, the Aryans spread from the Saptasindhu region to the plains and valleys of the river Ganga. They named this region as the Aryavarta, which means the land of the Aryans. Now, the question is, from where we can get the information about the Aryans? We can get information from Vedas. The Vedas are the most important source of information about the Aryans, written between 1500 BCE to 1000 BCE. The word Veda denotes knowledge. The Vedas are the most important of the world's oldest literary source. There are four Vedas: Rig Veda, Sam Veda, Yajur Veda, and Atharva Veda. Rig Veda is the oldest of the four Vedas. It was composed in the early Vedic period. Rig Veda contains 1028 hymns in praise of different gods and goddesses like Indra, Varuna, and Agni. The Vedas was also known as Shruti. The Vedas were part of the oral traditions which have been handed down for centuries by word of mouth. The Vedas were transmitted orally from one generation to next. The priest preserved the text by chanting Vedas as part of their daily lives and taught them to the beginners very systematically. The Vedic culture has been shaped by the rules relating to performance of yagnas found in Yajurveda and the Atharva Veda, and by the spiritualism found in the Upanishads. This Vedic culture were written down after a few centuries, and this period of the beginning of written tradition is known as the historic period. So, it was through the four Vedas developed by the Aryans that we came to know about their culture and lifestyle. Hence, this period is known as the Vedic period. Historians have divided this Vedic period into two. Number one, early Vedic period, 1500 BCE to 1000 BCE, and the later Vedic period, 1000 BCE to 600 BCE. Now, the early Vedic period. Political life. The lowest unit of society in the early Vedic period was the family or the kula, headed by a kulapa. Several families together formed a vish or clan under a vishpati. Next was a grama or a village, headed by a gramini or village headman. Many gramas together formed a Rajya or Jana ruled by the king or Rajan. The most capable person of the tribe became the Rajan. The Rajan was chosen by the people based on his strength. He was the protector of his tribe and was treated as a spiritual being. He was also required to guide them to victory in a war. Rajan was assisted by various officials, including the Purohit and the Senani. The Purohit was responsible for the religious duties and ceremonies, while the Senani was the military commander in chief. The king did not have absolute power. He was controlled by several assemblies like Sava and Samiti. The Sava was a small assembly of a few important members, while the Samiti was a big assembly where the entire tribe could give their opinions on the matters of state. Women also participated in these assemblies.